Alex Walker is joining us here in our studio at Proactive from eStar Resources. Alex, great to meet you in person.
Yeah, thanks very much for having me, Caddy.
Pleasure. So first of all, before we dig into the latest news, just introduce yourself and the company for us.
Sure. So eStar Resources is a Kazakhstan-focused copper, gold, and now rare earths explorer. We've been operating in the country for a number of years. We have four assets in joint venture with the national mining company Talkent-Samruk. And we have one newly acquired heavy rare earth ionic clay asset in the East Coast Sinai region. We're listed on the London Stock Exchange under the code EST in January at 5p. And we are very, very active in exploring in country.
You are very active because we've caught up quite a few times, actually. Mm. We spoke earlier on in the week. I know that you wanted to make it really clear to everybody watching, didn't you, that you are fully funded for all of this?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, we IPO'd on the 10th of January. We raised £3.1 million and having a net cash position at the time of £4.4 million. So we are well and truly financed for all of our programs this year, including our new acquisition, and well and truly into next year as well.
Okay, that's clear as day for everybody. I just want to pick up on this latest news then this week, the farm into heavy rare earth element project in Kazakhstan. Obviously, that's your domain. Tell us more.
So we have been reviewing, in the last 4 years, we've reviewed over 150 projects in Kazakhstan. We are well and truly across the board on what is available and what's interesting. And what we've been looking at in terms of investment and divestment is to look at projects that have a lower risk profile than our existing assets in terms of exploration. So what that means is lots of historical data and a very, very good value project. So a project that we should be able to receive a multiple of our invested value in terms of in fair valuation on a peer comparison basis on the stock market. So we've found that in this heavy rare earths project. It's in the East Coast Sinai region. Mm-hmm. It is 30 kilometres from an old operating bauxite mine, so the infrastructure is actually quite reasonable. And the project work that's been done up until about 1994 has put close to 20,000 tonnes of contained total rare earth oxides into an old JORC resource model. The important thing about this asset, the most important thing about this asset, is it's what's called an ionic adsorption clay. And what that means is it is very heavy, so to speak, in the heavy rare earths and has very few other what you might consider deleterious elements or other things. So it's very little in the light rare earths and has next to no thorium and no uranium in it. So in terms of an environmental footprint, it's incredibly small. The other benefit of these deposits is they're very shallow. So our average starting pit depth is about 7.5 meters from surface. So it's going to be very, very cheap to drill, very, very cheap to mine when we get to that point. And the last thing, well, there's probably two last things, I should say, the critical things with these sorts of deposits is the value of the basket of goods that you have. So the heavy rare earth market is much smaller than the light rare earth market, but much higher in average value. So the basket price for heavy rare earth rich projects like ours tends to be north of about $80,000 a tonne at the moment. So that's incredibly exciting. The liberation to get the materials out of the clays is also very benign. It's very, very simple. So it tends to have no crushing, no grinding, no difficult mining techniques, and it's a very benign leach attempt. And it's why most of the heavy rare earths are supplied from the ionic clays in the south of China, the vast, vast majority of the world's production today.
Okay. Lots of geology there. I like this. Yeah. It's very educational for me. You mentioned there in your answer, you said about the 150 that you were sort of eyeing up or choosing for or sort of cherry picking from, if you like. Does that mean there's a lot more to come, presumably?
I'm like a kid in a candy shop in Kazakhstan. It's almost problematic because what we really need to do and focus on is ensure that we're increasing value for shareholders as best as possible. And we've got four absolutely outstanding assets, which were the initial part of our portfolio. However, sometimes opportunities present themselves like this rare earths project, which it's almost irresponsible not to do because of the value of the earn-in. Of course, there's no cash out for this deal. So it's all money in the ground until such a time as we first half a million dollars We prove up the quality of the asset, and then after that, it's a share-based deal. So there's lots of other outstanding assets in country we continue to look at and review, but they have to pass a very, very high threshold before they make it into the portfolio.
You're very choosy. All right, Alex Walker, thank you very much indeed. Is there anything else you want your investors to know right here in the British capital today?
I would probably like to reiterate that we listed in January of this year, and since then we have made 3 gold discoveries. All right, 2 from our historic drilling, 1 in the Novo prospect, which we announced in end of January, which was 63 metres at 4.5 grams per tonne. And a new one, Eshkilitau 2, was announced at the start of this week, which was 14 metres at 2.56 grams per tonne. The other one we have was a discovery based on finding additional historic results, being the Southern Shabdar project. Fantastic results, 25 metres at 2.86 grams, a number above 20 grams, and importantly, 2 metres at 39 grams, quite deep. So on one exploration license of 4, we already have what we feel will be the start of 3 potential gold mines. So we think it's been a hell of a successful start of the year. And certainly this year's drilling is going to be very, very exciting for us.
And we should mention as well that next week you're at the one-to-one conference, aren't you?
Oh, absolutely, yeah. So in London for a couple of weeks, enjoying it. Meeting with investors and a one-to-one conference I'm very much looking forward to.
Okay, I hope the weather improves for you, Alex.
That would be lovely.
That would be good. Hopeful. But Alex Walker, thank you very much indeed for coming into
thank
the studio.
Thank you very much for your time. Appreciate
from
it.
East Start Resources here on Proactive London.